Now let us look at this example. In this example, these are the processes. We have 6 processes. This is the arrival time of each process, and we have the burst time of each process. See, in case of round robin scheduling algorithm, we'll maintain a queue, and that is the processes which completed their time quantum and still they are remaining, they will sit back in the queue. Let me show you how it will happen. So this is the Gantt chart. This is the Gantt chart, and we will maintain a queue. This is a queue of processes. Okay, so at time 0, here I have taken the time quantum as 2. At time 0, only one process is available, that is the process P1, and we'll execute the process P1 for 2 units of time. See, you can see what is the burst time of the process P1? Burst time of the process P1 is 4. Now you can see here the burst time of the process P1 is 4 and the time quantum is 2. 4 is not less than 2. So we'll follow this path and we'll execute the process for the time quantum. That means we'll execute the process P1 for 2 units of time. We'll execute the process P1 for 2 units of time. Now till 2 units of time, you can see there are 2 processes which arrived. They are the process P2 and P3. They are the process P2 and P3. So we'll put the process P2 and P3 in the queue. See, even though the process P1 is finishing at time 2, a new process P3 is coming at time 2, still we are going to put this P3 inside the ready queue before the process P1. So process P1 will finish its time quantum at time 2. So after this, it will be needing only 2 units of burst time. It will be needing only 2 units of burst time. After doing its task, the process P1 will again go to the ready queue. Okay, see it is a bit complicated. You have to focus on this. Let's do this. Again, we'll take this process P2 out of the queue. We'll take this process P2 out of the queue and we'll execute it for the time quantum, that is till 4 units of time. See, process P2, the burst time of the process P2 was 5, and the burst time is not less than the time quantum, so we have to execute it for the time quantum, right? So we'll execute the process P2 for 2 units of time. Now we have a time which is 4 units. Till 4 units of time, we have new processes which arrived. They are P4 and P5. The burst time of the process P4 is 3 and the burst time of the process P5 is 4. So we'll execute the process P4. So we'll put the process P4 and the process P5 in the ready queue. At time 4, the process P2 will finish its time quantum. It will come out. So we are going to put the process P2 in the ready queue again. Okay, now we'll take the other process. See, P2 has already taken 2 units of time. So P2 will now be requiring 3 units of burst time. Now we'll take another process from the queue and we'll execute it. And that process is the process P3. So we'll execute the process P3, right? The burst time of the process P3 is 2, and 2 is not less than time quantum. So we are going to execute the process P3 till 6 units of time. So the burst time of the process P3 will become 0. Now you can see we are executing the process for the time quantum. If the time quantum expires, then we'll see the process execution completed or not. But you can see for P3, the process execution completed. So we are not going to put P3 again in the queue. Okay, but for till time unit 6, P6 process also arrived. So we are going to put PC6 process in the queue. Okay, now every process inside the queue, we just have to take the processes, execute them for the time quantum. If the process is finished, then no need to put them in the queue. If the process is not finished, then we are going to again put them in the queue. So now the next process is P1. Take P1, put in the CPU. So the burst time of the process P1 is 2. So we are going to execute it till 2 units of time. So it will finish in at time 8. So it will become 0. So because the time quantum expires and the process execution completes, so process will go to the termination state. Okay, so now we have the next process, which is P4. So we'll take P4. The burst time of the process P4 is 1. Okay, the burst time of the process P4 is 1. That is, 1 is less than the time quantum. We are going to execute the process P1 for the burst time, and then it will go to the termination state. That means the P4 process will execute till time unit 9 and it will become 0. So we don't have to put this back again in the ready queue. Now the next process which is there is process P5. So we are going to execute the process P5, and the burst time of the process P5 is 6, which is not less than the time quantum. So we are going to execute it till time unit 9. So its burst time will become 4. After that, the next, because it is not finished, so we have to put it in the ready queue. See, if the process is finished, then we don't have to put it. But if the process is not finished, for example, P5 is not finished, so we have to again put the P5 process in the ready queue. Now, the next process which is available is P2. And the burst time of the process P2 is 3. So we'll execute the process P2 for 2 units of time, that is till 13. It will become 1. Now, because it is not finished, so we have to again make it go to the ready queue. Okay. Now you can see the next process which is arriving is P6. The burst time of P6 is 3, which is not less than the time quantum. So we'll execute P6 till time unit 15. It will become 1. After that, we'll again see, because it is not finished, so we are going to put it in the ready queue. After that, the next process is P5, and the burst time of the process P5 is 4. So we are going to execute P5 till 2 units of time, so it will execute till 17. It is not finished, so we have to put in the ready queue again. Okay, now the next coming process is P2, and the burst time of the process P2 is 1, and this 1 is less than the time quantum. So we will execute the process P2. We'll execute the process P2 till 18 units of time, so it will be finished. Then we'll execute the process P6 till 1 unit of time, so it will be finished. Then we'll execute the process P5 till 2 units of time, so it will be finished. Now you can see what is the completion time of these processes. So process P5 finished at time 21, process P6 finished at time 19, process P2 finished at time 18, process P5 finished at time 17, P6 already done. Okay, so you can see what is the completion time of each of these processes. So again, what we have done is, if this is a CPU, if we have multiple processes, we are taking one process from here, executing it for the time quantum, we are taking it out, putting back in the ready queue, taking another process, executing for the time quantum, taking it out, putting in the ready queue, and so on. So this cycle will go on, right? So this is the round robin scheduling algorithm. Let us take few more examples of round robin scheduling algorithm so that you can understand it better.